Congratulations with your new job at ESF Communications Director.
Thank you, Gabus, and hi everybody, thank you for having me.
As we all know, Italy is hit extremely hard by the coronavirus. How is life at this point in Italy, in Naples?
Yeah, well, it's true, coronavirus hit Italy quite hard. We are the third country in the world for a number of cases, and we're currently in a quarantine. In the last 45 days, I've been out just 3 times, so it's hard for sure. Also for softball, team practices are not allowed, so we train at home. And for me, I'm working more on conditioning, so more on my personal strength than on technique.
Okay. Your technique was always great, isn't it?
Thank you, Gabor.
What does the ESF Communication Director do?
Well, let's start off saying that I'm a newbie. I started this job in February, and it's definitely a different season than the one that I expected. So, going back to the question, what I'm doing in this month is basically taking care of delivering the news for ESF, so managing the website, newsletter, managing social media together with Dominica Mercanova as well. Usually the person that is in contact with the organizers of the tournaments and national federations. And also usually, we've been working quite hard on the streaming platform of WBSC Europe, which is baseballsoccer.tv. And along with Johannes Butler, we are streaming a lot of games from the past to give relief to all those people that are stuck at home.
And how are your experiences in your new job?
Well, first of all, I like it a lot. And of course, it's different from what I expected, as I said before, because at this point, I thought I would be preparing for the summer events. But I can say this has been incredible months. I am learning a lot, and I'm very thankful to the ESF board for giving me this opportunity. Also to Elena Novotna, which is the prior communications director of the European Softball Federation. And, well, I hope to do my part to grow the sport that I love.
Okay. Most of the ESF tournaments have been cancelled. What are your thoughts about this? Do you think we have a good chance on playing the tournament?
Well, this is not an easy question to answer for sure. Let's start off saying that ESF had no other choices but to postpone the championship to September. The decisions were made to leave more time to the national federations to play the national championships. What I can say is that ESF number one priority is the one to keep all the people involved in the tournament safe. But also it's true that the legal framework in Europe is changing constantly, as Kate was also saying, and we are monitoring the situation, and we hope to actually have an answer for this to give to you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. We met in Foley working our SETV broadcast during the Premier Cup in 2018. You loved working with us in the tent to command during the games. Do you see any involvement for SDTV for the European Cup for national teams in 2020?
Thank you for reminding me of the Cup in Berlin, which is definitely a fun time to remember. You know, I much appreciate your work, but this choice, live streaming is not up to yourself, it's up to the organizers. And I know you already have an agreement for the under 15, so I'm very happy that I will have the chance to work with you again.
Okay. And we always will help if we can, Elda. That you can be sure.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Thomas. I will remember.
Hope to see you in September. Thank you for information.
Hope to see you soon, too. Stay safe.